Wouldn't it be nice if you could hire the right people at the right time? That's a question, I guess, that many businesses face, and maybe there's a book that can deal with that. Predicting Success, Evidence-Based Strategies to Hire the Right People and Build the Best Team. And the author, David Leahy, joins us now. David, what prompted you to write this book?
Well, the main reason was the publisher, John Wiley, hired our firm, Predicting Success, to go down and study their top sales performing reps in the United States. We came up with an algorithm that said your top 50 look this way, top 30, and they used our software, the Predictive Index, to hire better and turn their sales force around. And at the end of it, the SVP of HR said, there's a book in it. We'd like to publish your book. And so that's how it started about 18 months ago.
What's the thesis behind how you come up with numbers or your philosophy, if you will?
So the software Predictive Index is based on adjectives, 172 adjectives that measure drives, primary drives, assertiveness, extroversion, patience, formality, and then in sales, empathy. Empathy is very, very strong predictor of performance in direct sales here in Canada and across North America.
Okay, so what they do is they answer a questionnaire then, kind of a thing?
Yeah, it's just two questions. It's it kind of
just two questions.
Just two questions, and based on tons and tons of research, we have a very laser crisp way of saying this person will have a sense of urgency. This person can push the puck over the goal line as far as closing deals. This person can be a great project manager. But just two questions.
Okay, without giving the house away, what are the two questions?
The two questions are based around how adjectives link together to predict how you are in front of others and how you really perceive yourself to be.
So you ask me those questions, how I am in front of others, and I say I'm tall or short, or, you know, like you go through those things, and then how people perceive you to be. And that gets me everything.
That gives you everything. In fact, we just signed a deal with Canada Company, which is for military folks that are moving into civilian life. And they have, a lot of them, for example, have a great ability to do details and follow sequence. Now we have a survey that says, yes, that transfers into a logistics firm. Mm. So we translate the data designed for performance in many roles, from safety and job risk avoidance to sales to, we even have a large bank, and we have a large sales company globally, Salesforce.com, is using it to calibrate an international pattern for top salespeople.
Is there a difference between the work you've done in the States and Canada?
The nuances are very similar. North American trends are very similar. I mean, we believe the war for talent is over, talent won, and so it's a big reason why the book's been written, is bringing analytics to help you understand the diamonds in the rough to add to diversity and selection, just like the military example.
Well, okay, did it come from a military background then?
The original Predictive Index was actually designed by Arnold Daniels studying at Harvard, and he used it to identify fighter pilots during World War II. Today, here it is, our 60th year in 2015. It's being used now for more industry and business than ever before. Human analytics is on a growth curve. We're a big double-digit growth across Canada this year, but absolutely a military background back in the 40s.
Isn't that something? Okay, so then, what are the benefits, I guess, of having the right people in the right business? Is it quantifiable?
Absolutely. We have a number of case studies on our website, but one that comes to mind recently is a major bank here in Canada had a 30% faster time to fill rate. That's substantial. We also had a...
Time to fill jobs, you mean?
Open jobs. That was substantial. We also know the cost of a bad hire is one times base salary, so it's very, very expensive. We've seen sales go up anywhere from 4 to 11% by having better behavioral-based people in roles, in the right roles, with the right cognitive skills, because the second software we market is a learning indicator, which measures how smart someone is in a cognitive way. So, you know, 4 to 11% is a normal revenue increase. We've seen accidents go down by 11 to 15% when I have someone in a role that allows them to work in a safe environment from a personality standpoint. So those are substantial statistics.
Okay, but the book is written about predicting success and hiring people. Why wouldn't I take the same predictive components and apply it to the staff I have currently on board, and does that work?
Absolutely. We know that people leave the leader, they don't leave the company, and so the best leaders actually use the Predictive Index from hire to retire. So I like the work that we've done with an NCAA team in Maine, Tim Whitehead, where he uses it to coach his players all the way through year one to year four. And a very good example of increasing engagement. As we know, a large percentage of Canadian employees, North American, are disengaged at work. The better leaders and coaches use data analytics to coach.
Wow, behavior-based analytics.
You
like
bet.
That. Okay, so then that's quite beyond the two questions that you ask, or how? What's the nuances? How do the nuances?
When I send you your survey, I think you'll be jazzed. But it absolutely gives us a management strategy, how people will work under stress, how they'll work with their critical connections. Their negative blind spots and positive blind spots are also data that's coming out of the predictive index when it's completed. So it's pretty complex.
It's more than just business, because I coach a lacrosse team, a women's lacrosse team, for instance, at the university level. I could use this. I mean, is there something that I could take home out of this book and apply it?
Absolutely. The best teams are teams where everybody gets along and has a specific role. As Coach Whitehead says at University of Maine, once I've selected a student athlete, the scholarship's been spent. I have to deal with that person for 4 years.
It's true.
Can't get the money back. So he was a great, and I write about it in the book, he was a great example of using this to build a very strong, successful, four-time national qualifier in the NCAA sports. So coaches, better coaches now, are using analytics to understand their players' strengths, opportunities for development, and also how they'll get along with the critical connections on the team.
Wow, that's interesting. There's more applications. We've got to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
We've been talking to David Lea about predicting success, and David, you were talking, we had a great conversation during the break too, but when we look at this and the application outside necessarily of hiring, how does it work? Would it work for a family, for instance?
Well, there's a lot of second-generation families, third-generation families that have transition problems, you know.
Yeah.
And so the classic entrepreneur we write about in the book looks a certain way, has a drive, maybe an ambivert, so sometimes technical, sometimes extroverted, very strong sense of urgency, and that just the right amount of details to push the puck over the net, or over the goal line, excuse me. Sometimes what happens is we spoil our kids, and that sense of urgency, that sense of drive is inherently not developed. So we do see that from time to time when we study first generation, second generation, and third generation families. There was a famous story that goes, you know, from clogs to clogs in three generations. And when you study the analytics, the top line, the first generation entrepreneur looks a very different often than the third generation.
Yeah, it's absolutely true. Okay, what you mentioned, empathy was a key predictor. Does that bias things towards females, for instance? Are you finding that females are more successful under this kind of a model?
You know, we do 2.2 million data points in North America with the predictive index each year, so I have an awful lot of data. The survey is not biased based on race, creed, color, sexual orientation, or gender. We are training more female leaders than ever before. More frontline leaders are females, and we are seeing that the drives are consistent. So that top line project manager, male or female, will still have certain attributes. They still will have that sense of urgency, that technical orientation in some cases, the sense of multitask, and a large capacity to respond to the environment. It doesn't really it's not affected by gender, so it's absolutely, we're finding a diversity enhancer by using workforce analytics.
Okay, same for cultural? Because you think of different cultures as being lazy or ones that are being hardworking, for instance. Are there cultural differences? Have you found that in your work?
Well, we have not. We have our predictive index is now available in 63 languages, so including Punjab recently in Vancouver. We just translated it. We are seeing that in North American business place, the enablers that we see are consistent across cultures.
Isn't that something? Small business, is this designed for big business? Obviously, you're hiring people, but does it work for small business?
Well, our largest client is over 55,000 employees, and our smallest has 3.
Really?
Yes, and so we were meeting with him just last week, and his response back, we said to him, why do you keep paying for the software? He said, well, the price of a bad hire in my small company is much more expensive. I have no place to hide the person, and so I need to have this enabler. I can't afford to have an HR professional, but your predictive index gives me a leg up on the hiring and also to coach.
Isn't that something? Wow. David, thanks so much. Very interesting.
My pleasure.
I'll go through it in more detail and see if I can use it on my team.
Well, love to have you try it.
Done. Right. David Lea joining us. Predicting Success. He's the author there.